There are gasps of awe and enthusiastic shouts of agreement. Count me in, me too, me three. When the cacophony dies down, one lone lovely creature speaks. That's wonderful, but it's not enough. What about everyone who doesn't fit into the binary of gay or lesbian, or man or woman? What about every sexual outlaw and freak of nature? Who's gonna fight for their rights? The thoughtful soul who had proposed AIDS to the group says, you're right, but I don't see how we can do it in one go. Ah, but I do, said the lovely one. I'll go with you. I'll go down with you, but I'll take another path while you take on AIDS. By the time you're finished, I'll be ready. I need the time anyway. I have research to do. I've been thinking that most of the Earth's problems are caused by gender. Gender on Earth operates like an evil cult. I need time to explore the nature of cults. I heard yesterday that someone's starting a new cult. They're thinking of calling it Scientology. I think I'll check it out. The lovely loner was not alone for long. Many in the AIDS soul group were so taken with the gender project that they volunteered to jump back into new bodies right after their AIDS lifetimes. Wait for us. We'll be back to join you. You'll recognize us. We'll be the cute ones with great haircuts, unrecognizable gender presentations, and creative pronouns. But we'll need to be caught up to speed quickly. Write us some books. Books we can read while we're growing up. Books that will help us keep ourselves safe and prepare us to fight the new gender revolution. And thus, it was decided. Albert Bornstein was born in 1948. He joined the Church of Scientology in 1970 and learned cults from the inside for 12 years. In 1986, Kate Bornstein was born. The overwhelmingly most popular answer is Kate Bornstein saved my life. As writers, we have all collectively and individually inspired lots of people. We've changed more than a few lives with the power of our words. But how many of us can say that our writing has saved thousands of lives? My fiercest pleasure to present the Lambda Literary Foundation's Pioneer Award to my beloved partner in life, love, and art, Kate Bornstein.
Tour and earn my own daily bread. an interesting side benefit of this wonderful outpouring of love and affection that I wasn't expecting at all. Your gifts and well wishes completely crushed, once and for all, my low sense of self-esteem. In the areas of gender, identity, and expression, I have many colleagues to thank, as well as writers I have followed, imitated, and stolen from. Their names are going to appear on my blog, but I do need to speak some names here tonight. Here we go. My path as a writer of books has been guided by remarkable publishing houses and editors, Serpentail Press, Amy Schulber, and Iris Silver. And again, Amy Schulber, T. Cooper at Akashic Books, Tristan Teermino at Cleus Press, Seal Press, Brooke Warner, Beacon Press, Gayatri Patnaik, and Routledge Press again, Erica C. Wetter. Thank you. I want to give love and thanks to Caitlin Sullivan, my co-author on Nearly Roadkill. Love and thanks to S. Bear Bergman, the outstanding co-editor of Lambda Award-winning Gender Outlaws, The Next Generation. Thanks to my tour agent, Jean Kayani, at Speak Out. Thank you, Gail Leander Wright, for the publicity that first got Gender Outlaw out into the world. I am forever grateful to my literary agent. I love you, Malika. My friend and mentor for over 40 years is John Amy. He's always pushed me into writing what's most scary to write about. And I recommend that to every writer here. Finally, the editor who's been looking at all my words for 17 years now is my boo-boo, my muse, my dear Zavi Barbara Corrales. Both souls outside of time and space, and we were deciding our rebirths, what we could do to ease the suffering of queer people in the 20th century. Well, it was Barbara who decided to make it her life's mission to pioneer ecstatic sex that would not spread the plague. Thank you, Boo-Boo. You brought ecstasy into my life and into the lives of all my children. Interesting times. For the first time, anything trans has come to public awareness on the planet. The face of trans belongs to a woman of color, Vivian. The literary face of trans belongs to a woman of color, Janet Mock. Belongs to a tranny of color, RuPaul. Interesting times indeed. What's more, for the first time ever, there are three generations of sex and gender theorists, artists, and activists all alive at the same time, each generation with its unique point of view, each with unique experiences and timelines. Well, I'm asking that we three generations of sex and gender artists, activists, theorists, and spiritual leaders come together in a pioneer coalition that deals with race and class within our community. actions of LGBTQQQIA, etc. to welcome family living well beyond those letters, for we are legion. Our legion of identities has the common denominators of sexuality, sex, gender identity, and gender expression. But because we live in a culture founded by Puritans, it is shameful to talk about this shit. Nevertheless, all of us are here tonight because of what? Terrific sex! And fabulous gender. Now, sadly, puritanical sex negativity shames us into invisibilizing our terrific sex and our fabulous gender, and sadly, institutionalized sex negativity extends into our own community. We shame each other. We're being mean to each other. We have got to shame, got to stop shaming sissies, sex workers, BDSMers, pornographers, sluts, burlesque artists, trannies, and drag queens. These are the funnest people in our family. Shaming these people and distancing ourselves from them. Well, that's a shame in and of itself. It's a puritanically generated mix of misogyny, homophobia, and transphobia. And I am asking you, as your old auntie, please stop doing that. Someone pioneer a queer community that doesn't eat its own. Dear Lambda literary people, may I be so bold as to tickle your own fabulous pioneering spirit. Please, Lambda Lit, could you kindly create award categories for sex education, queer spirituality, queer young adult fiction, more category for books written by people with sex and gender identities not yet expressed by LGBT. Okay, I'm wrapping up now. Here's the deal. I've got lung cancer and leukemia. I know, I might be around for another 15 or 20 years, and I hope to be, but just in case I'm not, I want to say this now. Please watch out for each other. Please watch each other's back. Please stand up for each other. Sally, go sissy your walk, children. You stay alive, have good sex, have fun with gender, and write great stuff about that.
Stage Lambda Literary Foundation board member, John Sibbick.